evening and welcome to yet another great game of BUCS Super Rugby. I'm here in Bath, the rec, for Bath versus Leeds Beckett. Today with me I've got your co-commentator, Matt Gilbert. Matt, you're a previous number seven for Bath Rugby. Tell us a little bit about the rec and how special it is to you.
Oh, it's a great place to play, you know, when it's full house, you know, under the lights, you know, it's a really good place. And you know, we're expecting quite a good crowd tonight, sort of 5,000-6,000, so hopefully they generate a good atmosphere for the two sides to play.
And how was it when you were playing for Bath? Any special highlights?
A few games, you know, like Gloucester games, always local derby, always quite good fun on a Friday night. You know, we had a good couple of years when I was here.
Absolutely. And also behind me, I've got a big gold number 50 because Bath are celebrating 50 years at the university. And with me also, I do have Aaron James, who's the coach for today's game. Aaron, if you want to come join me over here. Hello, how are you doing? Nice
good
to
yourself.
See you again.
Yeah, good.
So, Aaron, tell me a little bit about today and what you're expecting in terms of what the lads are going to produce rugby-wise.
Oh, we've come off the back of two good wins, so yeah, the boys are confident, but we haven't really been playing the way we'd like to and not quite as happy with our performance. So we're hoping we'll step up again and add to the two performances of the last 2 weeks.
And have we got any players today that are needing special requirements, injuries, anything, for example?
No, we've down our number 8, James Catlin, who's had two pretty good games over the last week. But, you know, we're going to go through it's a pretty long season where everyone's going to get injuries. So, yeah, we're reasonably strong. We've got good backup and good depth. So, as I say, just looking forward to seeing the guys go.
And as I said before, it's 50 years for Bath celebrating today. Are you doing anything special tonight with the boys?
We'll see. It's been a big day, you know, big day for the whole university and the sort of the finales down here. But it's important that we're thinking about a rugby game rather than just the whole big occasion on a pretty good stage.
Well, I hope that you could celebrate this with a win today. Thank you very much and good luck for your game.
Thanks very much.
No
Cheers.
Problem. And also I have the Leeds coach with me today, Mike Ashford. How are you doing? Good, nice to see you. So today we've got a big game coming up. It's going to be hopefully your first win of the BUCS tournament.
Yep.
How are you preparing for this today?
Pretty much last couple of weeks we've really played well. We're getting better and better each week, but we've just got to be a little bit more accurate, and that's been the focus for training over the past couple of weeks, and it's starting to come together. Hopefully it'll come together with a W tonight. So
I hope so. And so players today, anybody in particular to talk about, anyone to watch?
Josh Longson, the captain as always, big carrying game, he'll get over the ball, and that goes for our back row as well. We've got to counteract this big Bath back row, get across the pitch and make our hits. Also Sykes coming in at fullback should shore things up, kicking game, and also Harry Collier and David McIlwine, very experienced players, and hopefully should really lead us today.
Is there anything in particular you've been working on since the last two losses for you guys that you're going to implement today in the game?
Yeah, massively. Just accuracy in the red zone. In the final third, we've had a lot of possession and perhaps played too much rugby not to get the points at the end of it. So it's really a case of being accurate in that area and coming away with a lot of five-pointers, hopefully. So.
Fabulous. Well, I hope you the best of luck for today.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
Thank you so
Cheers.
Much. And off the back of that as well, I have Jack over here as well, who's the captain for Leeds Beckett. Hi, Jack, how are you doing?
Yeah, not too bad.
Good. So, coming into the game today, what can we expect from you and your team?
We've been working a lot on trying to keep the ball a bit more. We've been doing really well with it recently, but we've just been kind of letting ourselves down at key points, so kind of not losing control it when we're in the 22s and stuff like that. And then defence as well, just kind of aiming to get the ball back in three phases. That's kind of what we're looking at doing.
As your coach Mike said, Bath have a big, strong back row. What are you guys going to do to overcome that?
We've never been, well, especially this year, we haven't ever been a particularly big side, but it's never really bothered us before, so we're not kind of worrying too much about it. We're just going to get on with it and play as we normally do.
Fantastic. And is there anybody at all on your team today you want to watch out for? Tell the folks at home.
We've had a few new boys that have kind of been brought in today. So we've got a couple of lads on the bench, Tom Williams and Rob Flett, who've both been brought up from the twos purely for how they've been performing then. So expect them to make an impact when he come on. And then a lad called Johnny Key on the wing, who's been playing really well, a fresher.
So, brilliant. Yeah. Well, I look forward to it and good luck today.
Cheers.
Thank you so much, Josh.
No worries.
And the last person today that's going to interview is Will. Will, great to see you again. How are you doing?
Yeah, nice to see you. Yeah, I'm doing well, thanks.
Good. So off the back of your win last week, you guys prepared for another hard-fought match today?
Yeah, I think so. We just need to not let the kind of occasion get to us. Obviously, a big day for the university and we're expecting a big crowd, but all the boys are just going to focus on what they have to do to beat this Leeds Beckett team today.
Of course, and get your head in the game, yeah, focus on it. Is there anything on the coaching side that you guys are focusing mainly on to beat them today?
I don't think so, to be honest with you. We've started well this season and we're just going to stick to what we do well, whether that be line out or getting the ball out to our backs, but we're just going to stick to our game plan and see where it takes us.
In terms of opposition, last week Loughborough were very different from Leeds. Are you going to have to change up your game for today?
A little bit. I think Leeds do offer a bit more in the breakdown than Loughborough did, so they'll look to target us there. But they're similar in some aspects, as they're going to both be very physical. And there'll just be a big battle up front again this week.
Of course. Well, Will, good luck today and congratulations on the 50 years.
Cheers.
And we'll see you soon.
Thank you very much.
And coming back with me now is Matt Gilbert, your co-commentator. Matt, let's just break down the game a little bit for today. So what can we expect in terms of good rugby?
Well, I'm not sure about good rugby for everyone, but other fellow back row, you know, both coaches and the two captains have talked about the back row battles. So, you know, they lead the pit to a quicker back row and, you know, with them sizing it to try and combat the Bath back row and what they do around the field.
And the players today, anybody in particular we can watch?
Well, just, you know, speaking with the lead coach, they've got Johnny Skyton at 15 and he's, you know, talking about his kicking game and his experience and shoring up, you know, the back end of the field. So, you know, I think, you know, you can watch out for him.
Do you think the boys going to be a little bit distracted today with obviously the 50 year celebration? Big crowd?
Not really, I don't think. You know, everyone played in sort of occasions like this, and you know, once you're on the field, once the ball kicked off, you know, your mind's just on one thing, which is catching the ball and making sure you do your job well and as well as you possibly can.
Well, we've got kickoff very shortly, and going to be co-commentating with Matt as well is Johnny Bryan. So over to you, Johnny, and good luck.
And to a very special night for the University of Bath as the 50 years as an institution. 5,000 fans are expected to come through the turnstiles this evening on this, the climax of a day of festivities here at Bath and a BUCS Super Rugby game between Bath and the Leeds Beckett side, who are very keen to spoil this 50th anniversary party. Matt Gilbert's hot-footed himself from the pitch up and onto the gantry alongside me here. Matt, we watched Bath 6 days ago against Loughborough, and a very good performance it was. But do you think it was workmanlike, or do you think it was them showing the whole league that a bit of a statement, as it were, to say here they're here to challenge for this title this year?
No, they definitely played very well, didn't they? They've tried, they've scored, very good driving line-out game, good kicking game that we played about in the night. And yeah, they definitely did put down you know, a statement of intent, and you know, that being a heartbreak this week, they were talking about that.
Well, it should be an intriguing time, this one. As I said, about 5,000 fans are expected to come through the turnstiles here this evening. They had a big alumni party in the cathedral here nearby this afternoon, and it's been a big day of festivities here in Bath. But this Leeds side are going to come here, and they want to be party poopers, don't they? They're here to spoil this party.
Yeah, absolutely, and obviously they haven't had a win yet either in this Black Super League. So they've been playing well by all accounts, including their coaches earlier. They're pretty happy with how they've been playing. And they're pretty happy with how they've trained in the last couple of weeks, but you know, results haven't been going their way, so they're just looking for a bit more continuity in the games and keep hold of the ball a bit better in the opposition 22, and hopefully they get the points that they are after and the win that they need.
Well, absolutely, and hopefully it'll be a fantastic evening here for all concerned, whether it be for a Bath victory or a Leeds one at that. Let's have a look at the two sides in detail then. First of all, let's look at the Bath team. And they have made two changes from the side that beat Loughborough 6 days ago. Adam McCarthy comes in at 7 for James Catlin, and Tom Kinge moves to number 8. Levi Davis comes in at the expense of Dan Rowland. Their 15 looks like this. Palmer at 1. Doherty, who scored 2 tries against Loughborough last week and was the man of the match in that game, is the hooker at 2, Alex Wood 3, Will Britton 4, Jack Davis at 5, Michael Snook 6, Adam McCarthy 7, Tom Kinge, as I said, moves to number 8, Will Flynn at 9, Ludovic Hopkinson fly half at 10, Levi Davis 11, Charlie Dunbar 12, Craig Duncan 13, Jake Allen 14, and Hugo Stiles, who was 100% from the tee, he is
Rugby. So let's look at the Leeds Beckett side. And they start like this. Number one is Ryan Everly. Two, Harry Newborn. Three, Rory Mason. Four, Dan Preston Routledge. Five, Martin Dodds. Six, Luke Painter. Seven, Josh Longson. Eight, Jack Lambard. Nine, James Elliott. 10, Harry Collier. 11, Ollie Hudson. 12, Ben Dixon. 13, David McElwain. 14, Johnny Kay. 15 is Johnny Sykes. Squads have been warming up for quite a long time. It must be said, Matt, you know, you were a former professional player yourself, and you just said to me off mic that we half an hour, 35 minutes as a warm-up, and then in the changing rooms get ready. These guys have been out here for an hour and 15 minutes. Is that... They use a lot of energy just in the warm-up.
It was a bit bizarre, wasn't it? They arrived very early, both teams arrived very early, and I think, you know, they came in, they had a little walk around the stadium, you know, a lot of these guys, the first time they play at the rec, they come in, you know, had a look around the ground, and, you know, oh, this is quite nice playing at, you know, a stadium that can hold 15,000 people. But then, yeah, obviously they then retired to the changing room, got changed and thought, well, we're just sitting around here, they're going out and have a kick around and run around and stretch and soak up some atmosphere. But like I said, you know, they've been out here since, you know, 4 past 5. I thought to down there, didn't I? They're kicking off at 6, have we got this wrong? But, you know,
I mean, you were a little bit worried, weren't you? We're thinking, well, the programme must be starting in half an hour. These guys are out here already, but it's an hour, 4 past 5, they were starting warming up. And I think Leeds are earlier than that, so I think we've used up a little bit of the fuel tank before the game's even kicked off.
Yeah, maybe, but, you know, like at the occasion, well, you know, the occasion and the anticipation of the event will, you know, obviously give them all the energy that they need to play.
Something that made myself, Lottie and Matt laugh during that warm-up, there was a big golden 50 that was in the middle of the pitch that you may have saw Lottie was presented from at the start. One of the Bath boys with practicing their high kicks went straight into the number 5, and unfortunately that 50 is no longer with us.
Hopefully that's not an indication of how the 50th celebration is going to go tonight. Very good.
Well, hopefully, Matt, we'll have looked to have a smashing time, as it were. And that's my first one of the night, as it were. We're just moments away now, as I said, the crowd here below, well, you see a few of them to the left behind the goal from where we are, but there's a cast of thousands below us from where we're commentating from on the gantry and the hospitality tents and pavilions and boxes to my right in the here at the record. Full to the brim with alumni and staff and many other VIPs as well. And we've even got mascots here today as the lead side take to the field. And wait for the roar as the home side will be greeted by this very much partisan crowd. 5,000 will greet him momentarily. Was interesting fact to note that in the last 3 years that these two sides have met, Leeds have come out victorious on both occasions. And here it is, that roar that greets the home side, wearing special shirts tonight to celebrate their 50th anniversary of Bath University. And this is the climax of these festivities today, this BUCS Super Rugby tie. Is there a worry that the occasion might get to the home side?
I wouldn't have thought so, but you know, you obviously have to look at last year. Bath Rugby celebrated their 150th year, and it's probably the worst year they could have imagined. You know, so obviously this is just a one-off night and a one-off event, but you know, they've had a very good start to the season, so you know, they'll be quite confident they can continue that.
So then it's going to be Harry Collier from Leeds Beckett University. They'll kick off going from left to right. And a gorgeous evening here in Bath. Not a breath of wind. Quite warm as well for an October evening. and we're underway. Picked up by Tom Kinge. As Bath, in, as I said, in white today to celebrate this 50th anniversary. Will Flynn, former Bicton College player and alumnus from that sporting institution. That's Johnny Sykes, who scored a try against Exeter in there and won the first games for Leeds Beckett. Sends us from downfield and a decent kick it is too. So just these opening exchanges. Tom Doherty, who had a very good game last week against Loughborough, scoring two tries. Let's see how his honours are today. Flynn, to his right-hand side. Now looking left. Picked up by Michael Snook. Adam McCarthy now, in the 15. Bath trying to open up the scoring here on the front foot, given this very strong 5,000-seater crowd. Something to celebrate. Flynn. Styles. To Craig Duncan. Pirouette on a 6-foot string past Ryan Everly. Up to the 22. Bath come. Alex Wood stopped in his tracks. Hopkinson. Tom Kinge. Good tackle by his opposite number, Jack Barnard. Flynn. Hopkinson. Strong start from the home side, but Leeds keeping them at bay. Duncan. Dunbar. Bath yet to break the 22 line. Wood. Flynn, Styles. And Leeds will have the chance to clear their lines with a penalty. Good defence from the away side.
Yeah, not too bad. I mean, obviously the initial line break came from one player flying up. I think it might have been the number five, Martin Dodd. But, you know, he flew up on the man and obviously left it inside and outside, massive holes, and Bath University took the opportunity. But from there, they've just gone, you know, failure after failure, then tackle after tackle, and they got the turnover, the reward that they deserve.
They failed to clear their lines up. The penalty doesn't find touch. Sent down the throat of Levi Davis, who sent it back in field, and this is where we're at right now. Styles pirouettes on a 6-foot stand, much to the joy of the crowd. There's a little pocket dynamo, there's the fullback for Bath. He's played Hong Kong under 20s, and he was deadly from the tee last week. Hopkins, a little chip and chase, and collects as well. Needs a bit of help though. Stopped by his opposite number, Andy Collier. Picked up by McCarthy. McCarthy, this is Styles. Davis. Flynn. Michael Snook. But they're going to come for an earlier infringement, and the penalty coming in on the side. So a chance here now for being backed up in the scoring from the boot of Styles, or maybe a kick to the corner.
After that, the penalty advantage, though, Hawkins and Doherty decided to go for that little chip and shake, because, you know, if it doesn't come off, then, you know, you come back for the penalty. But I suppose the the advantage wasn't over, to be honest. Like, we gathered it, it made 20, 30 metres, but obviously the referee decided that they didn't get enough, and so they've gone for a corner, which last week they had a very good driving line out, so hopefully they'll bring that into the game.
Yeah, that was one of their strongest weapons in their arsenal last week, was that driving line. I don't think they scored three tries out of four, last week, so it is a danger. With Doherty and his arrows, and Leeds may have to combat here today. Flynn, having a look at this one. Snook, sneaking his way, 5 metres out. As Bath look to open the scoring, ball pops out though, and a chance maybe leads for them to clear their lines. They've been on the back foot for much of this opening period of play. And as you see that how strong the crowd is here, the stand is absolutely packed here underneath our feet. And a great atmosphere here as well.
Just looking back at that line out, you know, Bath had a bit of a nudge on, but Lee did enough just to force Bath away from it. And obviously it's much easier to defend the pick and go rather than having to defend a man rolling up the field as one.
Doherty just checking what the call is. It's good one again, collected on her. Here comes the drive again from Bath into the 22. Another strong drive going to gain a good 10 yards or so. Dunbar. Davis. And it will be Bath to have the possession.
Just looking at the way Leeds defended that line out. Obviously they know that Bath are a very strong drive, so they decided to step away from the line and not engage, so therefore the maul is not been formed, and so they can't pass the ball back to the man, otherwise there'll be an obstruction. I'm not sure whether the referee got a call there right, because Bath actually held on to the ball and a man came into an offside position, so you know they could have got a penalty there in my opinion, but obviously they did well to read the defence and they managed to keep the ball.
So first scrum of this evening on a beautiful evening here in North East Somerset. Pretty warm it is as well. You see on the field is steam coming up both sets of packs here. I don't know if he's going to reset that one. I'm surprised they can see each other in that mist of steam right now on the field. It was another strong weapon of the Arsenal last week was this Bath scrum. So Leeds again are going to have to be cautious here. I know how dangerous it may be. A good thunderous hit on it is needed as well. Flynn though picks up and goes left. Hopkinson. Michael Snook. Flynn. Chance for Styles here. Tackle was needed and was made by Everly. Flynn. Not a good tackle well by Josh Longson, the Leeds captain. Drop goal attempt. Doesn't happen, but they are going to come back. For a penalty, and it's right underneath the posts. And a good opportunity here for Bath to get on the scoreboard.
Yeah, they've had the penalty advantage, so obviously going for a drop goal gives them two attempts at getting the 3 points, but also shows a bit of respect to Leeds defence, because they're not really managing to break them down. Obviously they gather a couple of penalties, but Leeds are staying quite strong and quite together, and they're all making their tackles. We haven't seen any green line breaks, and so there's not really a lot for Bath to go to.
So not opting for the kick of post. A little roll of the dice. And maybe going to their trump card here. The driving line hand, which is what we saw against Loughborough last week. And here we go again. Here comes the drive. Lee's trying to hold strong. Just gaining 1 or 2 yards maybe. Doherty. Just 1 or 2 metres out. Picked up. Snook. May have been turned over here by Leeds. Will have a chance to clear their lines. And the Yorkshire side hold out for how long? Levi Davis with a good take. Uses his dancing feet but doesn't get past. The lead number 14K. feet just dropped into touch, and it will be a line out. But they're a little bit disappointed there, they didn't come away with the score.
You got to think about the driving line out. You know, they had a good driving game last week. They looked like they had a little bit of a nudge on, but I can't imagine the referee called them to use it that. So, Doherty scored a couple of tries last week from the drive. He's got to only leave the drive when he knows he's definitely going to score, or if the referee told them to use it. And I think then he maybe panicked a bit, thinking they're not going anywhere, and it just bowed out on his own, and ultimately he lost the ball.
And a nice little run here from Ben Dixon. Dixon needs a little bit of help, and he may get it. Hudson. Number 11 on our sheet. Barnard. Thunderous hit. Ball has been dropped, but it's still in the Leeds Beckett possession with Longson. Now on the first chance attack opportunity, we've seen Leeds get into the Bath half here. And can they collect something from it with Rory Mason? Collier. Ben Dixon. Nice inside pass, and it could be an opportunity here for Leeds to go on the board. Needs an tackle from Quinn, and an excellent tackle it was made there by Will Britton, but still Leeds have it, just short of the line. The strong tackle, that may have been turned over here and pinched, but it was illegally, and it will be Leeds who will have the penalty.
Just a difference in the two teams are Leeds' first opportunity to get the ball past the fence, a few missed tackles there, and obviously they've gone 60, 70 metres up the pitch, and I can imagine Bath were under a huge amount of pressure, and they've made a clinical error there, which has, you know, been considered a penalty.
And they're opting for the scrum by the looks of things.
If we look at the two defences, obviously Leeds look like they're very, very much in control, all staying connected, all staying together, and I don't think they would have felt under a huge amount of pressure, but Bath boys, you know, gone slightly ones and twos, a few missed tackles, suddenly you're retreating, and you've got so much pressure that you make decisions that you shouldn't really be making.
Elliot with the put in, looking for his options, but maybe they're just going to kick this one over, but they come again for another Leeds penalty. Well, for them being under the cross for the first 10 minutes. Right now, Leeds are the ones who silenced the crowd. You hear a pin drop here at the wreck right now. All the students below. Bath faithful, right behind the home side. A little favourite to score. This first 10 minutes, but now Leeds are really wrapped the pressure up here on the home team. Another scrum coming your way here with Elliot. Again, Leeds are strong as well. Another penalty coming their way. Trying to kick this one over the line. Excellent scrimmage in this from Leeds. And then over. Jack Barnard, the scorer. Excellent work from the away side, and they get the first score on this Tuesday night.
The referee awarded a penalty there, and obviously they're going forward as she feared that Bath have been fringed, but I'm not sure why she hasn't gone for the penalty try, because Bath Leeds can continue to move ball forward. And I mean, ultimately the try scored, and maybe she would have gone for a penalty try had Barnard not got the ball down.
Well worked though.
Very good try, and obviously they backed their scrum having gone for the penalty. They could really have taken 3 points and obviously restarted the game with 3-0 lead. But they backed their scrum, you know, they're a big bunch of lads, and you know, they've got their reward.
Indeed they have. Well, I mean, under the cosh, first 11 minutes from the home team. They're the ones that get the first score on the board for the first time they're entering the Bath 22. This is David McElwain on kicking duty at 13. This to take maximum points. Sends it on its way and in the heart of the goal. So Leeds, Beckett University lead here at the wreck for the first try of the game. Coming from Jack Barnard by 7 points to nil. Respond. Hopkinson goes deep into the 22. But high into the night sky.
picked up by Styles. Flynn spots a little bit of a gap, opening up, and goes for the line. It's keeping in play. I think they may have just... So counter-attack being launched here from Jack Barnard, the try-scorer. Elliot. Ball charged down. Easy to clear, and Elliot does.
Just interesting to see the charge down, whether the man was impended or they tried to get up with it again here. You know, from our first view, he made a good effort to charge down. The kick had taken far too long to take the kick. But as he tried to go for it, they've been tackled there. And you know, the referee or linesman have seen that. But whether that could have been a, you know, an opportunity, definitely could have managed to try possibility.
Well, the officials here don't have the view that myself and Matt have up here on the gantry, and what you see at home as well. But it's a chance for Bath here to respond. 5 metre scrum. Short arm penalty. Tompkins picks up. Scrum down, they'll go again. Flynn with the put in. The referee are not happy again. Giving both sets of backs their instructions once more. Very vocal crowd we had here at Bath 6 days ago against Loughborough. They were singing the songs. There was very much a party atmosphere there at the sports training village last week, but they've been silent so far this first 17 minutes, but for how long maybe? Flynn with the put in. Picked up by Kinch. Opportunity here for Bath to equalise, and they have. Thunderous reception for the home side as they get back on the scoreboard. As Charlie Dunbar, a former Leicester Tigers Academy player, gets over the line. Much to the delight of the 5,000 strong crowd here at the Wreck.
A bit the vibe that's gone through there. I mean, if you look at the scrum, we're toward the left, which means that the lead back row are actually in the game on the open side and out of the game on the blind side. So I'm surprised they took the option to go open, but obviously maybe a pre-called move, and the number 8 can't help with it regardless. And it, obviously they've got a reward from it, and you know, we got great game building.
Indeed, we have. I think both these sides really gone out on the front foot. Styles didn't miss a kick last week. And he continues from where he left off. We're level. 7 points apiece as he puts the halfway point of this first half.
I think just looking back and how they got the try and you know, how they got the field position, obviously it came from the restart and then the lead kick long to Bath had to kick back to the corner. Rather than lead kicking straight out, they hit forward in the midfield on the 22. He didn't have a long way to go. He could can't kick, you know, can't press forward to kick himself. And so they've carried, and then they've created a platform for the kicker to kick. He's taken far too long.
Picked up by Doherty. The pass inside to Michael Snooker misses out. Elliot. Atmosphere just beginning to build here now at the Wreck. With an advantage being played here, yeah, as that one goes high into the night sky. Oh my word! Well, he gets a bouquet to Styles. He's straight up on his feet, but he did very much a Max Whitlock type somersault there in midair. But thankfully he's okay.
Was he with the cheerleaders earlier? No, I mean, it didn't look too bad in terms of they were all looking at the ball. It didn't look like he was taken out in the air, and obviously, you know, everyone very lucky and very fortunate that he's actually done a full flip and ended up on his feet. But, you know, we depending on the view of the linesman, obviously they haven't got a TMO. It could have been an opportunity for, you know, a card there, but it looked like the referee just seen that they're both looking for a ball and they've run into each other. And luckily, the 15 of Bath has not got injured.
No, indeed, and then like Hugo Styles, you know, I think he looks. I mean, he was an agile athlete. And somebody catches the ball in the crowd, much to the delight of this home side. In fact, it was the mascot who picked up. Well done to him. Harry Newborn now, of Leeds Beckett. Goes long. Elliot. Puts a little bit of a gap. Tackled by Jack Davis. Picked up by Jack Barnard. Mason. Longson into the 22. Sykes. Elliot. Collier. Elliot surveying his options and goes down the blind side again. Ball popped down and a good tackle it was too. By Craig Duncan. Chance for Bath firm to clear their lines and they do have a knock-on advantage. That's indeed what they're going to be coming back for.
Just think that's what the lead coaches were talking about earlier the game to us in the preview, that, you know, when they get into the red zone 22, they need to hold on to the ball. I mean, they made them good indent there with the pick and go, but all you have to need to hold on to the ball there, and they can continue to break through the Bath defence.
For the loudest cheers in the night. Farther more to come. Party atmosphere here in Bath as they celebrate 50 years of university here today. And a good scrum it is from Leeds Beckett. But it will be Bath who will have a chance to clear the line to the penalty and send this ball downfield. So does he find touch? Oh, yes, he does.
That's a pretty good kick there from Huddington, because they've gone from 22 to almost 22. They've both can look to have a nice strike play, maybe look go first phase or a second phase move to obviously dictate where the lead defence goes so they can strike. And have a second phase game line.
Flynn. Hopkinson. Advantage being played, and here's the penalty. I mean, the chance here for Bath to take the lead of the kicker if they want to.
So, as I was saying, they went for the midfield hit, and you could see the 15 went from the open side and choked down the blind side. So, he's obviously the trigger for the move to go back. So, they're waiting for a lead to send too many people around the ruck, thinking the play is going to go the same way, and then the 15 coming back and taking the ball off the 9 and obviously playing with 15 and a couple of forwards and his winner.
Bath fancy a little bit of a gamble. They've already turned down 2 attempts at goal in this first 24 minutes of the game. But they fancy picking up all 7 here with their trump card. Doherty And now here comes the drive. But Leeds will have the chance to clear.
Yeah, I'm not too surprised that the penalty there. I spotted that on the first line-out, 5 minute line-out they had when they had a penalty. Number six, if you watch number six, he's just going straight into the back of the lifter and giving him all the protection in the world, and then they're trying to drive through the back of the pair of them, which is obviously what they did last week to score a couple of tries against Clapper. So, in a sense, he's actually creating a block and they're driving onto him, but the referee done very well to spot that, and they're blocking. So, Leeds can be very happy that they've got a halfway line-out.
Indeed, it's been very much an even contest right now, I think. I think it'd be fair to say, Matt. I think first 10 minutes, Bath had all of it their own way, and Leeds have one attacking opportunity on the counter-attack and scored, and Bath with the reply straight away. But I think, so far, on balance, I think it's been quite a fair contest.
Yeah, I think it has. You know, both teams have had a bit of set-piece play and a bit of dominance in set-piece, and then, like you said, Bath have had a lot of possession, but Leeds have got a bit more of a line-breaking attacking game.
So penalty going Bath University's way.
It's a little bit unfortunate. He'd not gained anything from the blocking. He'd actually gone backwards and tackled to be made, but you know, the referee obviously felt that there was deliberate infringement.
Well, the kick doesn't find touch, but it still puts the away side under pressure. There's no need to clear. Box kick downfield from Elliott. Comes back into midfield into Hugo Stiles. Stiles to his right. Picks up Hopkinson. Hopkinson to Jake Allen. Allen into the 22. Tackled by Johnny Kay. Flynn. Stiles. Doherty. Flynn again. Picked up by Dunbar. Both these sides. Mason. Tackled by Hopkinson. Elliott surveying his options. As Leeds trying to dig their way out of their own half. Up high into the air, picked up by Stiles under pressure. Kay and a thunderous hit from Johnny Kay. To stop Stiles in his tracks. The crowd didn't like that one, but it's still with the home side. Bob pops out, Flynn needs a little bit of help with this one. The offload is another thunderous hit, this time by Jack Barnard. And here we go.
I think with doing a couple of bits of foul play there, I thought the referee should have made a call on the early tackle in the air, which could have been a yellow card offence, which obviously the crowd were booing for. And then that there, it looked like a very good hit, but with the hit, whether he used his arms or not, I'm not sure whether he'd run them and collide with them. It's a bit unfortunate, he goes arm up, a bit of a swinging arm, but the guy does duck his head into the arm. And obviously, because he's hit him with touch impact, it does make it a lot worse than I think it actually was.
We'll try score it after 10 minutes in the bin after half hour.
And unfortunately for the referee, she hasn't got the benefit of the doubt for the TMO, which she obviously having the Premiership matches. But I think the linesman could have maybe helped on the early tackle from the high ball.
So justice done there, in your mind? A little bit of justice done there?
Yeah, I suppose so, but they've got a line out now 40 metres, but you've got to ask more from the kicker, the Bath kicker there. You've got to expect them to get the ball much closer to 22 so they can have a much better attacking option.
So Leeds, a
are going to finish the half with 14, or close to it. Flynn, Hopkinson, little kick forward, but Bath fullback Johnny Sykes there to clear it out, sweep up. There will be a line-out on the halfway line. Doherty, picked up by Britton. Styles doesn't get past McElwain. Hopkinson. And the ball's been turned over here, leads his way, and they will win the penalty.
Just looking at the way Leeds defend the line out, they've got a flat five, they've got their winger, their open side winger in the line, flat, and they've only got the fullback and the blind side winger in position. Fullback standing in the middle of the pitch. They, you know, Bath obviously looking to play off the line out, but actually they're just getting confronted with a flat five defence. It might be a good idea if they were to switch it up and actually put in a kick behind. But there's a lot of faith in that open field grass and actually put a chase on, or if they put it in behind for the line out, then Leeds, they've got to change the way they defend to stop the ball getting kicked behind them. Then it gives Bath more opportunity to attack against a 4.5.
Just imagine this is the first of three games we're showing you this week. We've got a triple header. We're up to the northeast tomorrow night. We've got Durham against Cardiff, and then we're back in the northeast on Friday night for Northumbria against Loughborough. Plenty of university rugby to be seen this week, but this is the first one, this triple header, and it's been, well, it hasn't let us down so far. As Leeds looking to spoil this Bath party that they're having here today, celebrating their 50th anniversary. Right now, we are being party poopers, and they're doing their job, frustrating the home side. Hudson. James Elliott, going to his left-hand side. Good offload there, good hands from Dan Preston Routledge. Stopped in his tracks by Doherty. Still in Leeds' hands, and nearly the opportunity for the interception, and Leeds breathe a sigh of relief.
Yeah, I mean, Leeds aren't going too far. You know, obviously they've got a man down, they've got to think about that. The forwards have got a little bit of gain line, but you know, Leeds just need to think about the yellow card management and trying to run down the clock as much as possible. You know, so here, you know, look to reset the scrum a couple of times, waste a minute. Obviously, keep the referee on side, but you know, they need to get to half time without conceding, and obviously come out in the second half with all 15 men on the pitch.
Eventually, the average is 7 points. When you're kind of one man advantage, so the average score is you can see 7 points. You know, is that what's up? Or maybe Leeds will be looking for here, just a score of sorts, you know, especially with that one-man advantage.
Sometimes the yellow card can galvanise teams as well and give them a bit of input, especially if they feel a bit of injustice on the yellow card. But, you know, obviously Leeds are playing well here with the ball.
For an earlier penalty. Beg your pardon, knock on, it was the decision, and it will be Leeds who will have the put in. But similarly, you mentioned, Mark, that might be correct. That's, you know, sometimes when you do go to man down, you see this in football as well, when a player gets sent off, it does galvanise the team and the more stronger defensive unit.
Yeah, absolutely. You know you've got to work harder because there's left people. I mean, really, you should be working as hard as possible anyway. But because you've got a man down, you think, well, actually, I better work a bit harder because, you know, we are a man down. And you know, obviously, sometimes you don't notice the missing man. you know, the main ball carrier that had been Thunderman, so you know they may be lacking a bit of go forward for the next, you know, the 10 minutes or so remaining, not even the 5 minutes or so remaining, not even Thunderman.
Yeah, Jack Barnard, the man in the sin bin right now. Also, the try scorer of all Leeds, Beckett.
The Leeds have gone for the eight man's scrum. They obviously, you know, both scrums have been quite competitive tonight, so they've opted to put the winger in just to ensure they don't lose the ball and give away a penalty. And obviously, they've got a free kick for an early engagement.
Picked up by Ben Dixon. Maybe Leeds are the ones who will be sensing something here. Preston Routledge up to the 22. Elliot Longson. Into the 22 he comes, tackled there by Flynn and Doherty. Dodds. The tackle there by Tom Kinch. Elliot. Collier. Elliot again trying to fish it out, and they do have an advantage to come, and the penalty. You take three here.
I think they've got to take three, you know, obviously, like we were just talking about the yellow card protocol, you know, for this team. If they can get a penalty and take 3 points, obviously another minute off the clock, another minute off the yellow card, 4 minutes to go to half-time, and 3 points in the lead if they get a successful kick.
So, yeah, another opportunity here for David McElwain to likely, maybe, give Leeds a lead head into the half-time break. But one thing you notice that this Leeds side have done in this first half, they've silenced the crowd. It's one thing that I've seen with their play, they've been keeping the crowd very quiet.
Yeah, they have, you know, they've made line breaks here and there, they've broken through tackles and they've actually made them good lines. And, you know, if they take the lead here, I think they're actually quite, you know, worthy of it. And while they've been under pressure in their own 22 for a large period of the game, then you know, they have made the most of the opportunity they had to have the ball and they have made the line breaks.
So another 3 minutes left to play. So McElwain, this
says
to give the Yorkshire University a 3-point lead. And it's missed on the left-hand side. Well, opportunity wasted.
You'll be pretty disappointed in that. You know, obviously they worked hard, they've got a penalty, and you've got to bet your kicker to get that. Not really the most difficult kick in the world.
No, I think you might be a little bit disappointed with that one. So, it's as you were, seven apiece. Leeds just landed under 14, men still for another minute or so. But during this 10-minute period, they've been the one who've been asking the questions of the home side. Styles! Knock that one forward. It's a knock-on advantage to be played here. And a little kick to the corner. It's a good one, but they're going to come back for that knock-on and a scrum in midfield. Leeds won't mind that, just to run the clock down even more.
Yeah, I'm not sure whether she would thought about putting her arm out for offside there, because obviously the lad knocked on, hit another Bath player in offside position, but she put her arm out, but I'm a bit surprised only for the scrum. But I do say, you know, a couple of minutes left, a scrum, whether they go for the number 8 is back on now, they're back to full complement. So I think, you know, Leeds have got to look to get another penalty here and just take the 3 points and go in at half-time in the lead.
So about a minute or so to go. Just to give you an idea, the clock on your screen is only an indicator. We still go on the referee's whistle. We have had one or two stoppages. Leeds are pushing. Good strong scrum has been again from Leeds. That's their little weapon of their arsenal. Styles, block from Kay. Under pressure of the home side once more. And wow, the shout, the Leeds Beckett players are absolutely screaming for a forward pass. But instead it goes into touch.
A bit of a few different incidences there, obviously the crowd getting a bit excited, but you know, here we go. I mean, whether it's a forward pass,
to look forward to where we were up here. We don't have the best view in the world.
Oh, my word.
I'm not sure. Oh, it looked like it's
marginal.
It looked like it dated along the line, though. I think we throw that sideways and therefore not forward. But just going back to the last scrum, as a forward, you know, if you've got the nudge on, you want to try and keep the ball in as long as possible. And as we spoke before the scrum, if they could have got a penalty there, that would have been an excellent outcome. And you know, if they'd kept the ball in, I think they might have got a penalty reward.
So we're in time added on here, on our clock.
Go, Greg!
David McCowan. It may have been turned over here and gone the home side's way, but so by a knock on and we'll come down again, but a scrum which probably won't be the last phases of play in this first half.
Josh Longton did really well there, the seven. You know, he managed to counter-rack. He got into a position where he was able to put his hand on the floor. But unfortunately for him, I'm not sure the number, but his, I think it was the number six, came in and actually hit him from behind, knocked him off his feet, making him in an unplayable position off on the floor and out the game. He just needed to support his own body weight and help the man in front of him, and they would have had a turnover. But now they've got another scrum. And you know, I think it could be the last play.
Elliot with the put in. Kick downfield, and spots a little bit of a gap there, does Harry Collier. Deep into the 22, going to be picked up by Jake Allen. Styles hoops this one into touch. And the referee looks at a watch, and that will be the end of play in this first half. And an interesting first half it has been as well, Matt. It's one try apiece, one conversion apiece. I think a fair reflection of where we are right now. Bath 7, Leeds 7 at half-time. Let's have a look at some of the highlights as the players leave the field. Let's have a little 10-minute break. Let's have a look at the first try, and it came from Leeds Beckett's number 8, Jack Barnard. Keep your eye on him at the back of the scrum. This was after 10-12 minutes of the first half of Bath pressure. But it was one trip into the inside the Bath 22, and Leeds come up out of it with maximum points.
I mean, we spoke about this earlier. They've had a bit of dominance in the scrum, and you know, they actually went for this is the second time they had a penalty. They decided to go for it again, and like I said in the game, I thought the referee might have given a penalty try, but obviously she's given the opportunity for the number 8 to actually score. But if he hadn't, I think she would have gone under the pace.
So that's the first try. The second one came from Charlie Dunbar. Excellent pickup, spots the gap and uses his weight to get over the line. And that was, well, more or less, well, 3 or 4 minutes after the lead score. Conversion taken by Hugo Styles, which gives us a level match and an interesting one at that at the break.
It's just an interesting one at scrum time. You know, both teams look quite dominant on their own ball, but defensively, They seem to maybe lack concentration. You would have thought one team would maybe have the dominance throughout the whole game. And you know, looking at the last couple of scrums, Leeds have definitely had more of a nudge on. But they've obviously decided to play away, which, like I said earlier, you know, may be a bit disappointing for the forward. But you know, they've had a good kicking game in behind. The last couple, they've actually kicked it, put in behind Bath, and made quite a lot of territory on the game.
Here's one of the instances we were talking about earlier. That was the hit from Johnny Kay on Styles that you thought was the more illegal one of the two that we did see Barnard go in the bin for.
Well, he's half a faction too early. You know, the Bath fullback done very well actually. You know, he got his knee up as he'd gone up to protect him a little bit, and maybe that, you know, actually convinced the ref that he's not been hit badly, because actually as the catcher, he's done a very good job of getting his knee up, giving himself a bit of distance from where the ball was going to be and where the tackle is coming from, and that's actually made it look a lot better than, you know, it actually was. But you know, for me, that definitely an early hit and potentially could have been a yellow card.
Well, this was the yellow card. Keeping out of good. Flynn does well to recover here, just scoops that up. But then we've got a couple of slip here and a slip there, and this is Barnard coming in. with the shoulder. And, well, did you think that was a yellow card in your mind?
A little bit harsh, the closer view now. Obviously, the ball's built at the back, they've got to be massive, so they've just chucked it about. And, you know, here's the number 8 coming in now. The good hit, but, you know, it's come in with an arm, yeah, an arm's leading, and he's caught him on top of the head, and obviously he's gone down. You know, all the bit of the frost that kicked off afterwards makes it look a lot worse than it was, but I think, you know, on the whole, it was the right call.
So that's where we are at the end of this first half. One try apiece, one conversion apiece. 7 to Bath, 7 to Leeds Beckett. Interestingly enough, Leeds Beckett are still out on the field. They're having their team talk. Right now, to our left, they haven't gone to the changing rooms. They're right underneath the post to our left-hand side, and they're staying out there. They can see on the screen. They're having their half-time team talk on the pitch, so they're continuing ready to do battle. They're not going inside for a half-time cup of tea. They're sitting on the field and having their marching orders underneath the posts.
It's a bit strange. You don't see many teams doing that too much anymore, but obviously we don't know yet what their setup is at home. Whether they, you know, their training room might be a long way away at home and they're actually used to coming out. But it's a bit interesting because, you know, when you play a night game, you go in at half-time and obviously it's very, you know, it's light, it's bright, it's warm, it's cosy. And you get a bit comfortable sometimes. Then you come out and suddenly, like, you know, your eyes have got to readjust to the floodlight light, which is a lot different to, you know, the lights in the training room. A bit chilly, you know, and it may give them a bit of an advantage. You don't know. You don't know whether they're actually getting cold, just stood there in a huddle, you know, trying to get some body warmth from each other, and actually we may see them start slowly because they're cold, or we may see them have more of an advantage because they're adjusted to the environment and the situation that they're going to be playing in.
Let's look at the first half as a whole then, from both sides. A fair reflection, the score, 7 each, from what you've seen so far?
Yeah, I would have thought so. I mean, you know, they probably had a good 20 minutes each. You know, the first 10 minutes, Bath had all the ball, all the possession. Leeds defence very solid. And then, you know, obviously Leeds had the ball for 2 minutes, make 50, 60 metres, get the penalty, get a try from the penalty. So, and then the last one had just been a bit of both teams. Obviously, I think Leeds can be happier with their attacking shape and their defence, but neither team are managing to keep the ball for long enough period to break down the defences and get the point that they want.
Well, this is what the half-time entertainment is right now in for the crowd. It looks like the mascot's having a little bit of a race and then a little kick a goal to keep the 5,000 people entertained here at half-time. We're going to keep an eye out on what they're doing and keep an eye on the team. The Leeds team is still, by the way, on the field. They haven't left yet.
I'm not sure what Daffy Duck has got anything to do with University.
That's what we've been asking all that. I'm going that away first time, as it were.
There we go, we've got a few hurdle jumps. 3 hurdle jumps, going on to...
I think is that skipping rope?
Yeah. Skipping rope.
Skipping rope. Well, the bear's doing a lot better than the duck right now. Well, the bear's not even skipping at the minute. He just had 2 goes at it and just decided, there it goes again. And one more time. And now the duck is actually doing very well with the skipping. But the bear has dropped the rope completely and now is doing a little bit of a weave in between the posts. The duck's still a mile behind. And the bear nonchalantly going in front of the post with a little kick at goal.
Thank you.
Oh, the duck's got it in straight away, oh dear. That's like one of my efforts. And the bear, it's not too bad, you know. Just wide. But I think the bear may have defeated the duck there.
I think he cheated a bit. He didn't do the skipping the whole way. He gave up on the skipping. The Bath duck did very well with the skipping. But I'm not sure about the ball placement that was on the conversion.
Well, it's the first time I've commented on a mascot race, looking at it that way. But anyway, let's chat about the rugby that we've seen right now. What do Bath need to do in the second half, in your mind? And Leeds on the reverse of that as well.
I think, you know, Bath looked good. You know, they kept the ball, they were very patient with the ball. But they need to find ways to break Leeds down and change the way Leeds are defending. And as I mentioned, you know, they've got a lot of men in the front three. They're almost defending with you know, 13 in the front field. So there's a lot of both in behind. So, you know, Bath, while they haven't used their kicking game, they could look to kick a bit more and put Leeds under pressure to return those kicks. And in turn, Leeds will then look to maybe put 13 on the front line, so 12 on the front line with 3 in the backfield to try and cancel out all the kicking and having people back there to be able to return those kicks. Just from Leeds' point of view, I mean, obviously a lot of their tries, a lot of their line breaks are coming from just a breaking play and missed tackles from Bath. So, but as they spoke beforehand, their coaches spoke beforehand, they actually need to keep the ball for longer when they get into that 22, into that red zone, and keep compiling the pressure on Bath. And Bath will make mistakes, like everyone will make mistakes. And, you know, they'll get their penalty, they can kick the corner, they can get their driving line-out game going. And, you know, they just need to go, you know, 3, 6, 9, 12 in the second half with the pressure they can put on Bath with the penalties.
Well, interesting enough, Leeds have now just gone into the changing rooms. They've had the team talk outside, and now as Bath begin to make their way out, Leeds are not now trying to go into the changing rooms. You're shaking your head at me here. You can't understand the logic.
It's a bit odd, you know. The Bath players, you know, the Bath subs are now coming back out, and obviously, you know, when you go in at half time, you've got to go in and get some fluid on board. You know, some people like having a snack bar to get some more fuel on board, and go to the toilet, do those sort of things, change some taping, you know, change your shirt, change your pair of boots. There's lots of things you do in changing room at half time, and yeah, it's very odd that they stayed out for the amount of time they did.
Well, they've gone into the changing room for about 70 seconds.
And all used one toilet.
Yeah.
They're just joined here with Zach Mercer. He's been playing for Bath in the last few weeks for the Bath first team. Just obviously here watching tonight. Just get the thoughts on the game on the first half.
It was an interesting first half, wasn't it? I mean, you'd probably say Bath should probably be a couple more points up in that first half, especially with the Leeds Beckett yellow card. They probably should have capitalised on some more opportunities. But I think it's been a pretty good first half, and the competition's there, and I think it's going to be an interesting second half as well. Everything to play for.
Thank you very much, Zach.
Yeah, as I said, Zach, it's a great little festival here today. You know, with Bath University celebrating 50 years, but I think Leeds have actually come here to give them a game and looking to spoil this party.
I don't think Leeds are here just to play. They're obviously here to compete, and it's a good atmosphere down there. I just walked up here, and the atmosphere's been pretty good. But yeah, Leeds are here to spoil the show, I think. So they're not here just to let things go, really.
I was just chatting to Matt. He's giving me his thoughts on what to expect in the second half. Let's have yours. What do Leeds need to do, and what do Bath need to do?
I think Leeds just need to keep ball retention and keep hold of the ball and put back under pressure and keep them in their half. I think Bath have got a lot of flair out wide, and I think we've still got a lot to see from Levi Davis. I think the number 11's got a lot to show, and I think when he gets the ball, he's dangerous. So I think Bath, when they're getting their 22, I'll put money on to score every time.
What's your expectations?
Bath win. That's what I'm hoping. Actually, it's weird because I was born in Leeds, but played down in Bath. So I think Bath will end up too strong for them.
That's a nice little mist to just come across the ground right now. It's and it is scrum down. Leeds ball inside the 22, and as we begin this second half, and it's interesting. It's like the John Carpenter film, The Fog, has just come out of absolute nowhere, and it's just come across the ground here at the wreck, and it's making visibility just a tad difficult for up in on the gallery. But look at our cameramen are poised and ready to help us out. As Bath have the scrum inside their own 22, as they look to clear lines, but Leeds are strong that scrum again. It's picked up by the Bath and Blade, Tom Kinch, Flynn, Hopkinson, kick downfield, Johnny Sykes looking to pick up and does so, and a kick back downfield, coming to the end. Now that ball just disappeared in the fog from where we are, and I've just now luckily I think the players have got a better view than what me and Matt have up here. That's Johnny Kay. start this second half. Interestingly enough, as I mentioned, they spent most of the half-time break on the field, having their orders at half-time, and then went back into the changing room for about 90 seconds before coming back out. And they still seem galvanised. As I said, Mark was just chatting to Zach as he left, as Elliot hits this one downfield, the box hit, picked up by Alan. Styles now. Good hit by Josh Longston, the Leeds Beckett captain. Flynn. Dunbar. Levi Davis, nice offload. Craig Duncan now. Good tackle there from Ollie Hudson. This miss has just got even worse in the last minute or so. We're really struggling to see from where we are. You can see on the camera now from where it is. Just come out of absolute nowhere. Johnny Kay. And the kick coming our way. Elliot into the stand. You're from around these parts. Where's this miss flunk come from all of a sudden? You know, you've played it a few times. Did this ever happen for you?
No idea. We're carrying on. I've not seen this before.
It's like the John Carpenter from The Fog, if you've ever seen that from the early 80s. When the pirates just come out of nowhere, you know,
We're just looking at the start of the second half. The both team kicked it a lot more. There's a little bit of kicking battle there. Bath will be happy with that outcome. They've made 30 metres on that kicking battle.
Well, let's put the cameramen under pressure, because they're going to have to help us after they hit up in the commentary box, because right now on the other side of the field, we cannot see a thing. Flynn. Styles. Tom Doherty. Good tackle there from Dan Preston-Routledge. But up to the 22, the home side come. Flynn. Hopkinson. Kinge. Flynn. Hopkinson. Michael Snook. Just shy of the 22. Running the phases on the home side. On the far side with Adam McCarthy. Well, Flynn, good offload. So Hopkinson with the run. Over the game line they come into the 22 now, and they have an advantage to come. Flynn, Styles, inside pass, but back they come for a penalty. I'm just such a stupid. That other touchline now, there's people walking there, and I can just see like figures. literally the last 5 minutes, it says fog's come from nowhere.
Yeah, we haven't got the best view up here anymore, have
we? We don't get the best view in the house, but now we're struggling a little. But Hugo Styles will be the one. Will be the one to try and give Bath the lead. 10-7. So we're not the only one up here, by the way, you know, up in this gantry. They're coming with us. We've got the analysts from Bath as well. So the rustling you hear is that they brought a packet of sweets with them, by the way. So apologies for that. You know, they're giggling away to my right. But Hugo Styles now. This, though, to give Bath a 3-point lead. Of the tee as the ball leaves the stadium. Hugo Styles has not missed a kick all season in this BUCS Super Rugby season. 6-6 he is now, and Bath lead 10-7. You can see on your screen there how gloomy it's become here. I know Halloween's Monday away. A week away, but right now it's Bath trying to give Leeds the fright here. And another. And that's it for the ball, knocked forward. Referee's happy. And Leeds have the putting.
Maybe another takeout in the air there, you know, but you know, the referee don't seem to be getting too much help from her linesman, to be honest. You know, you would have thought the linesman had got one thing to look at when the ball's not near the touchline, that is what's going on around the ball.
Well, in this fog right now, I'm surprised you can see.
No, absolutely, but you know, she'd made a call just for the scrum, but again, you know, if she had a TMO, might have gone back and had a look at it.
Penalty to Leeds. Apologies for the little giggle. I think we're a little bit guessing in a way right now because the weather has just come in all of a sudden here. Here in Bath at the Wreck. And the last... I have no idea where that ball's just landed, by the way. There we go. I can just see the touch judge's flag through our camera position, and the guy's doing a good job here. I'm guessing it's not too bad down pitch side, you know, but up here it's really is just turned into a terrible gloom all of a sudden. That was picked up by Sykes. Apologies if I might get a name or two wrong here. It's difficult to see from that far away as the ball hoofed into the air and into touch once more as Leeds look to clear, and into the 22 they come. Just outside their own 22 they come. It's a little bit difficult for us now. I think we need to play on this side of the field so we can see what's happening.
Yeah, just going back to that, obviously Leeds had a penalty from the scrum, went to the line-out, but you've got to win your own line-out when you're 15, 20 metres from the try line. I mean, they've got lucky. They're not a great kick from Bath, and they've got another tackling opportunity just outside 22.
Picked up by Rory Mason. Collier, good inside pass to Ben Dixon. Oh dear. Painter. The guilty party on that occasion.
A bit poor there from Leeds. Obviously, first phase attack. You know, the forward should know where they're going for the second phase, and they've all come round off plan. Ten's obviously not sure he's going to him, and the ball just been passed, and obviously, you know, it's hit Comerson in, unfortunately, the ten's offside. So, you know, now Bath have obviously got the opportunity that Leeds had 2 minutes ago.
So just got a player down receiving a little bit of treatment right now. That's the Leeds number five, Martin Dodds. So we do have a little bit of a break in play. Because the game might have just gone a little bit, I don't know what's about, a little bit quieter all of a sudden. It's been a bit much more of a battle of the first 10 minutes of the second half.
Obviously a little bit of a kicking game, that early, those early changes. But to be honest, both teams just aren't holding on to the ball. I mean, we've seen, you know, the line out, and then we've just seen that play there. You know, the line out wasn't even successful. From Leeds there, for the second time in a row, but they got the ball back, and then they've just come round the corner and just made an error and given the ball back. So, you know, Bath just need to win this line out, maybe look to drive with their big forward, and just keep the ball and get some continuity, and the penalties will come, then they can extend their lead to 6 points.
Tom Doherty with the line out. will collect it. And now the drive on once more. This, the ace in the pack for this Bath side. They can cause a lot of damage with this, and they continue to. Doherty right at the back of that drive. Picked up by McCarthy. Flynn wants it and has it. Hopkinson. Dunbar. Ball has been turned over, leads his way, and the kick puts it high into the ether, and it does not go out of play. Styles is the one man who picked it up. Good tackle there from Ollie Hudson. Ball out, and may have been turned over once more on the far side of the pitch. Difficult to see from where we are on the gantry, and even our cameras are struggling to pick it up right now. Ball goes into the air. Craig Dunkel underneath it and collects well. And now they're trying to launch the counter-attack there of their own. Duncan into midfield. Stopped in his tracks as he approaches the halfway line. Flynn. Dunbar. Davis. Flynn going to his right-hand side. Adam McCarthy just shy of the lead 10-metre line. Flynn running the phases of the home side. That's Doherty, the hooker, but Leeds will have the chance to gain some bit of momentum here from this penalty, and good defence from the away team.
They're not too bad defence. I mean, Bath had a very good line-out, a lot of complex movement, enabled them to reach the ball at the back and drive the end one man, obviously Leeds having to scramble and get their men into the drive. But you know, two turnovers from Bath, one on the 22 and then one on the kick chase. And, you know, Leeds, they've got their reward for a bit of resilience in defence. And, you know, it's now their turn to have a go. They've lost the last two line-outs. Well, not lost them, but not had them cleanly. So they need to get this one clean and try and get a drive into the game to draw those Bath forwards in. And then they can have a strike and just got to keep the ball and, you know, maintain pressure in that red zone.
Newborn. Intercepted at the line-out from Doherty, who burrows his way forward like a demented mole there. And a little bit of a take there from Jake Allen. Hopkinson. Duncan. Davis. The wide outside. It's McGrath. Oh, ball is stopped. Four. Just trying to see what a forward pass, but the looks of things, I think it was a forward pass, Matt. Such is the difficulty of the conditions here right now. Even we can't tell what's going on from up here.
It's not the best year, is it now? And obviously, you know, for you guys watching at home, you know, there's not an awful lot to do with the mist. There's not much we can do about it either.
No. I think we do need a little bit of a breeze all of a sudden. Maybe that might help. But there's no wind here whatsoever here in Bath this evening. And it has got considerably worse in the last 5 minutes. Now we're struggling to see just below us now. The far side, I think it's just a washout for us. We can't tell what's going on from about 70 metres away right now. It's such as this mist, or a fog now, has just descended here in Bath. But you can see on your screen, you know, from one touchline with our cameras to the other, you can't even see the other stand when you could about, 25 minutes ago. So we have a scrum on the halfway line. We think.
I just think from the perspective in the game, Leeds obviously 3 points behind. They've got to try and build some pressure now, and whether they can get a penalty from this scrum or potentially just put a kick in behind. They're a bit of faith in the backfield. They get a kick in behind and put pressure on the Bath line out. But unfortunately, they've given away a penalty for it looked like just the referee just going straight diving into the hole.
So then, opportunity for Bath to gain some territory and a little bit of momentum as well. Hopkinson with the ball in hand, his right boot's going to go down in towards the corner. Sending that one on its way. Just in between the 22 and the try line. And you can guess what's coming.
We know they've got a good drive of the game. They've obviously got to be very conscious. They've got picked up by the referee for blocking that back driver. We spoke about putting a blocker in on the back lifter to try and shield the bat and then drive through the bat, which is obviously what they've done very well to get their momentum going forward. So they've done it again, but the number six has not been a little bit more subtle and come in front or behind the lifter, and they've managed to get the rumble on.
Well, they are driving towards the line. We can't even tell who it is over there, but we just see an army of bodies heading towards that try line. Well, there's a bit of an idea from that camera view. Leeds need to hold out here. 25 minutes left to play, only three behind. As they continue to try and burrow their way forward, only 4 metres out. Just a little bit shy. The Leeds defence needs to be resolute here. As we saw Bath do this 6 days ago against Loughborough. Are they over? Are they over? They are! Alex Wood, we think, from 70 metres out. Let's have a look here. This is the best camera view we can give you because the mist is that bad. Well spotted from our referee. Well, somewhere in the middle of that is Hugo Styles, and he'll be looking to add the extras here. Styles in the mist, in the distance, to add the extras and to give the home side a 10-point lead. And over it goes. So Bath lead by 17 points to 7. Points the difference between the side from Yorkshire.
Leeds just invited pressure onto themselves there, that was their own scrum which Bath managed to get the territory from, and obviously the penalty and kicked the corner, and as we said last week and we've said this week, they've got a very good drive and they just paid dividends. Obviously the drive didn't take them all the way to the line, but it got them pretty close, and the big set forward is going to be very difficult to stop.
Lewis Brown on the field for Leeds Beckett. That's one of the replacements. Good tackle taken there by Adam McCarthy. Leeds need a response and quick. Elliot. Onto the line there, far right hand side, into the odds, past the halfway line. With number 8, Longson. Reliably in form. Newball. Dixon, McElwyn, yeah! And Bath win the penalty. McElwyn not particularly pleased with that decision as he retreats back, and Bath will send this one into the deep.
Very good tackle from the winger there, you know, very good turnover. Obviously, you know, a good tackle, put him on his own, isolated, and there's no one else to clean the winger out, and he's done well, kept his body shape, and very, very well deserved turnover. I'm sure Bath will do their their sixth man line out here with lots of movement, which Leeds haven't managed to stop yet. I mean, Leeds are doing a mirror and they're trying to follow the movement, but because there's so much movement, people are getting lost within it all, and they can't actually compete and get up. So, maybe they need to change their way they're defending and actually look to just to gamble on where they think it's going to go and just put a pod down and hope for the best.
Doherty, who's been pretty decent from the line this evening, and well picked up as well. Doherty at scrum half, gives it to McCarthy. Up to the 22 they come. The home side looking to try and put this game to bed. A loose pass. Good kick was needed. I think that came off the number three, Alex Wood. That's what it looked like to me with the deflection. And it has been given. Leads his way.
It's a different tactic there from Bath. They've gone for almost a dummy drive where they've just pulled out straight around and hit us two forward. But, some good defence out there from the lead stick, the painter. And, they've got the turnover. So they just need to just keep the ball and try and build them pressure themselves.
Loss of the line-out. Picked up by Tom Kinge. Flynn. Hopkinson. Now into the ether they go. Coming back this way. Flynn goes to his right-hand side. Hopkinson, that's Levi Davis. That ball looked forward, even in this fog, and indeed, the referee spotted it.
It's getting worse and worse this year, isn't it?
Seriously, my eyesight is not too bad, but even in this condition, it's just... I have no idea where the ball is going. It's so difficult. You can't understand how difficult it is from where we are right now to try and comment on a game when we can't see any numbers. Just bodies, as it were, in the ether, in the distance. This wasn't in the weather forecast. Well, we think it's a scrum. I think Leeds number 9, Elliot, has got the ball in hand and he'll have the put in. Leeds in response here, they're 10 points down. Even 3 points will do right now. Set up a finish of sorts. And now they're doing a little bit of running rugby of their own. And a little bit of space opening up here for the Yorkshire side. With Ben Smith. Smith gets past one or two players and as they approach the halfway line. Thunderous hit though by Charlie Dunbar. Spot a gap opening up for Longson. Come on. Elliot.
Stop him.
Dave Cogger. Gaining a few feet. Elliot. Ball has already been turned over with Flynn. Ball lost though and knocked forward. Not an advantage to be played here, and an opportunity wasted for the away side.
It's a couple of chuckle attempts there by Bath, and good turnover. But you just got to feel that Leeds have just got to hold the ball a bit more and have a bit more composure. I mean, he's got a turnover, and the path is on, and that 14 could do a better job holding onto it. But Bath would be quite happy with the line out. Is it a line out or are we going for a scrum?
It is a scrum. There's knock-on advantage to be played here for Leeds Beckett. As they're one of their players is receiving a little bit of treatment right now. 5,000 here this evening at the Rec. We have been reliably informed between 4.5 and 5. Nods around me saying that is correct. So a great spectacle is what they've seen here this evening. But the next score vital. The destiny where the points are going in this game. we'll try that one again. Put more time being run down here. And I said the next score, you feel, has to go the away side's way if they want to take anything from this game. Good scrum again from Leeds. And they win the penalty from it. And they're absolutely delighted with their efforts there. And that is a decent kick. That is into the 22. And an attacking opportunity to come here for the away side. Superb kick action, in fact, from David McElwain. And he says about that, Leeds need to get something out of this here if they want to take anything from this game.
Yeah, they've got faith with the starting hooker, but he has missed about four already tonight. So, you know, just hopefully the odds are in his favour to hit this one.
Newborn. 7-8 metre line out. Finds his man on this occasion. And now they're going to try and give Bath a little taste of their own medicine here. They catch a drive. And they're not doing too bad either. Danger for the home side as the away team sense a try and they've got it. Josh Longson, we think, is the man to get over the line. Let's have a look here. Number 15, Johnny Sykes, Mr. Reliable, he says on my sheet. Well, reliable by name and nature, by the looks of things. He's got reduced the deficit to 5, and this point, this kick here for McElwain to reduce the deficit to 3 and set up a true grandstand finish. Beckett can still go anyway. The crowd doing his best to put him off. As he sends this one on its way, and he's done an absolute beaut. 3-point game, about 12 minutes to play.
That's a great nudge. That's a really good kick, you know, giving them the opportunity to play the last quarter. Last 12, 15 minutes. You know, they've got maybe a bit of a momentum shift, having scored the last drive. I mean, pretty much the first line out they've got a success on. It wasn't even a great process or a great lift, but they managed to get something together, won the ball. And a few backs adding some more weight, and they've got over the line.
Yeah, well, I think Leeds were indeed giving Bath a taste of their own medicine, and they're really now looking now to spoil the party here. As Bath University celebrates 50 years today, Leeds are the Beckett are the ones on the front foot. That's one ball's been gone high into the mist. Ball went backwards, so it's still picked up, and with the home side. Jack Turner now, active scrum half, picked up by Austin Hay. Calling for reinforcements on the left-hand side. Turner, Hopkinson. Ball's lost and picked up in Leeds territory on our far side. Now picked up by Rory Mason. Stop him. Elliot. Coming towards this near side with Marshall. Good tackle there on Ben Smith. And Bath win the penalty from it.
The really good spot by Louvre Ogden. And, you know, he saw the play going out of the bat and he went out and spotted the man. He got man and ball. And the referee made the right call there. You know, number 20, he's got to either let go of the ball and stand up and play it or just or present.
Yes, Hopkinson, the man. Who wins the penalty for the home side. 10 minutes to go. Is that going to stay in play though? It's not going to. As Louis Brown sent it backwards.
and they'll have the chance to clear up towards the halfway line. Taken quickly though by Doherty. Turner. Styles. Hopkinson. Davis. Turner. An advantage is being played here for the home team, and Leeds are calling for reinforcements on this near side. Kick up high into the sky. Good take by Ben Smith, but back they come for a penalty. With 10 minutes left to play. Getting exciting this, isn't it?
Yeah, 3-point game. 10 minutes, as you said, you know, I think it's going to come down to who makes the least amount of errors. And, you know, an offside penalty, pretty soft. And you're just inviting Bath to put that drive onto you once again. Just need Huddington to get into corner, and it does look like a pretty good kick.
Yeah, we are. I saw what looked like a ball in that fog go in towards the 22. And indeed, that's what he's done.
I think we can expect the back shoulder drive again here. You know, it's worked for them the last couple of weeks. Just Lee just needs to hit that man at the back and you know, change his body shape so that they can't drive through him. They've got that up here, number 20, I think it is, with the red gum cap, will come into the back and protect him.
And here is that drive once more. Slowly but surely they're going for it again, right at the back of. Picked up by Turner. Stopped in his tracks. Doherty, acting scrum half, spotted a little bit of a gap, but he's stopped by Ryan Everly. Ball maybe not forward then, and indeed it has done. The referee has given Leeds that knock-on advantage, and back they'll indeed come for the scrum, and chance for Leeds to clear their lines, to tether on 22 with, 9 minutes or so left to play.
I just think, you know, Bath had a good drive there. They've worked their way into the midfield. The picture for the backs hasn't changed. It's still sort of, you know, 5-6 back versus, you know, 5 or 6 in defence. And, you know, they need to change the picture before they release the ball. And unless the referee is telling them to, which I don't think she would have done because they're still going forward, they've got to keep the pressure on and just keep moving toward the line and put Leeds under pressure to make mistakes and give away penalties. And it could have been a 3 points in front of the post and they would have been 6 points clear.
Tom Doherty leads the field. George Frampton coming on at hooker. And his first job is to get in the front row for this scrum. So then, Leeds from that scrum. Good tackle there on Ben Smith. Huge roar from the crowd, as he said the whole Bath may have turned it over, but still in the hands of the away side. Elliot Marshall in the troops. Box kick. Who wants it? McElwain's under it. Good take throw from Jake Allen. Turner. That's Scott. That is Austin Hayden, to beg your pardon. Good take again from Ben Smith. Doesn't find touch with his kick. Sends it back towards Stiles. Turner was thinking about the kick. Instead gives it to Hopkinson, the fly half. Now there's a chase is on here between Davis, who tackles his man, but offloads to Longson. Picked up by Mason. Ball pops out, and Leeds will win the penalty. And chance to send this one downfield.
Just looking at the kick battle they just had there, you know, a couple of kicks down to Jonah Marshall, the winger for Leeds, you know, taking a lot of time to have a look through where the space is, and in that time, Bath managed to get someone back into where he kicked it straight to him. If he's taking a few paces forward and just banged it long, he's got so much space in behind that defensive line because it's, you know, a bit of a scramble kick turnover ball. He's got a great opportunity to put it in behind them and chase and force Bath under pressure to kick it out, and, you know, Leeds end up with a line out, you know, further the way possible, 40 metres, but under more pressure could have been, like, you know, 30 metres out, which they've now got.
Scott Russell coming onto the field.
We've been pretty disappointing all evening. It just looks like there's far too much movement, not enough attention to detail in the lift. And, you know, I thought, well, they had made dummies because I thought they were going to go to a simple one at the front, which was a dummy, a lot of movement. And then, you know, Bath have still managed to pick it off and put them under pressure, and obviously they've knocked it on, and, you know, they've lost all that pressure and momentum they gained from getting the penalty.
5 minutes left to go. Lead scrum. Turner with the putting. 3 points the difference. And again, Leeds very strong from that scrum, but it's been picked up, and now the chase really is on as Bath trying to put this game to bed. On the wide outside, they may do here. Styles looking for a run himself. Good tackle though from his opposite number, Sykes, and has been intercepted by Leeds. They're going to launch a counter-attack of their own with about 4 minutes left to play. Oh, another thunderous hit. That's a momentum up wide here, and there's a bit of opportunity opening up here, especially on the right-hand side. For the number 20, Ben Smith just coming inside. The man over on the far side there for Leeds. They may have stolen something here, just shy of the 22. Sykes.
Drop him.
Elliott looking at Savannah's options and goes to his left with Sykes. McElwain. Good tackle there from Craig Duncan and Jake Allen. And Walsh with turnover. And half the bench was celebrating onto the field for that penalty. As Bath win the penalty, a lot of the crowd are celebrating right now. The AC is 81 on the clock in the stadium. If they're right, and ours is only an indicator, they may have just won the game. Up in towards the gantry. But we continue.
Just before I go back to something else, he hadn't gone very much distance there. I'm not sure whether he thought
the
last play there. It looked like the Bath winger, which is going to kick out quickly. The ball was taken off him, because obviously it's not the last play, but then Hopkinson had just kicked it, you know, to a touchline. But just looking back at the last phase of Leeds play, I mean, the miss must be quite bad down there, because they've missed number 14 twice in a row on a 2-on-1.
Well, it must have been one of the last few plays here. Well, we got 2 minutes on our clock. The clock stadium here says 82, so it's maybe one of them in between. So we may be running towards one of the last few phases of play in this game. Turner finds touch, and that is full-time. Bath celebrate 50 years as a university, and their rugby squad comes off trumps here. They have given a stern examination, though, from the Leeds Beckett side. They've come here on the back of two defeats, but they've shown their no mugs as Bath take the victory here by 17 points to 14.
Matt. Good game in the end, even though the weather hampered it a little. Excellent game of rugby.
Not too bad, like you said. You know, we couldn't turn an awful lot in the second half, but yeah, you know,
we couldn't see like, we couldn't see a lot in the second half. a bit difficult for everybody.
Full credit to both teams. You know, they had a go. You know, looking at the game in the whole, the scrum was good for Leeds and for Bath, but you know, the difference between the two teams with, you know, Bath actually had their line-out with working, and you know, Leeds, their line-out just didn't function all night, really. They had one line-out they did get right, they scored a try from. But just looking at the last like few minutes that Leeds did have the ball, they missed a couple of turn one, which they could have actually given them a chance to nick it at right in the last moment. But, you know, Bath have now won 3 on the trot, and Leeds have now lost 3 on the trot.
Well, indeed, yes. So Bath go 3 from 3, Leeds 0 from 3 right now. But you feel from what you've seen with this Leeds side, that's, I think, a win's only going to come be just around the corner from them. I thought their performance was excellent here today.
Yeah, I mean, like the coach said at the beginning, you know, they feel like they're performing well. You know, they're scoring point, but they're not scoring enough. I mean, I know that, you know, too easy to say, and they've lost because they've not scored enough points, which is obviously the whole point of the rugby, but they've had opportunity, they've had the ball in the 22, and they're just not keeping it for long enough periods.
Your thoughts on Bath? Did they actually just get the job done here tonight? Much like last week against Loughborough, just got over the line, workmanlike, but tonight I thought they were given more of a tougher examination with this lead side. Think the occasion got to them a little as well?
Yeah, I think so, Johnny. You know, I thought that last week they looked a lot more organised, didn't they? Although, you know, with the Loughborough team that did have a lot of changes, and you know, potentially Loughborough went a bit light last week, and Bath made the most of that. But you know, they just seemed a little bit more organised last week, and you know, their drive in the game a lot more. But then, you know, full credit to Leeds, they did manage to defend the drive on the whole.
Just to remind you as well, this is the first of 3 games we're bringing you this week. Tomorrow we're up in Durham as they host Cardiff, and then on Friday Northumbria will host Loughborough, and myself and Matt will be back next Wednesday as Hartbury host Northumbria. And first chance we will get to see Hartbury, who from what Matt's been telling me are going to be one of the favourites for this Super Rugby title this season. But we'll chat about them next week when we see the rest of chat about this team tonight. From what you've seen tonight and last week, are Bath going to be challenging?
Yeah, Bath have got to be through contenders, haven't they? You know, they played 3, won 3. You know, they haven't played Cardiff Metropolitan yet, who, you know, have been very strong. And, you know, they haven't played Durham either, who, you know, have had some good results. So, but they, you know, they do look good. They got a good set of forward. They had a good bunch that came on tonight. You know, some good impact, didn't they? Number 19, you know, Scott Russell made some great carries at the middle there. And you know, they're looking good. You know, they look well drilled. They look well organised. You know, they're going to be difficult to break down. And you know, teams have got to find a way to stop that driving line out and their line out game all together, which is very good.
A man on the match, if you had to pick one. Ooh, yes.
It's a difficult one. I mean, you know, can we go for man of the half that we saw?
Sorry?
Can we go for the man of the half that we saw before the myth came in?
Before the myth came in. So yeah, it's a little bit of a difficult one. But of the 30 you've seen tonight, or both squads, who had impressed you the most, or is it a case of it can't be because there were so many good workmanlike performances? It was a workmanlike effort, you would feel, from both sets of sides tonight. It wasn't anybody really stand out. It was a team effort.
Yeah, they're good team effort. I mean, if you look at the try scorers, you know, Dunbar scored from a driving line out, you know, breaking out driving line out. Alex Wood scored the prop from you know, the dry line out and the pick and go, and I suppose, you know, the Bath scrum was good all night, the driving line out was good all night, and you know, Alex Wood would have played a part in that and all of that. So you know, a combination between, you know, Alex Wood and maybe the, you know, the main line out guy, Will Briston, the captain. So you know, they both did a very good job, and obviously Bath forward got, you know, got them in the game, you know, on the whole. And so, you know, someone like Alex Wood, I think, would be a fair winner of the Man of the Match award.
Absolutely, indeed. Lottie's down pitch side with a few people to get their thoughts. Let's throw down to her now.
Mike Ashford from Leeds. Coach, commiserations to the game today. What do you think went wrong?
In all honesty, I just think it was our accuracy. I said before the game that was exactly what we've been working on. We had dominance at the scrum, which I thought penalty-wise we were dominating everywhere in the set piece coming round the corner. But once we got into the final third, our line-up ball just wasn't good enough. We were living off scraps and giving our mistakes and giving them possession. And for the score to be that close with that amount of possession given away is just a sign of what we need to improve on. It should have been a win.
So it was highlighted to me at the beginning of the match that Bath have a really, really strong back row, big defence. Do you think that let you down today?
Not quite. I thought our back row was exceptional. I thought over the ball we dominated there. Perhaps around the field in contact-wise they got over the gain line a little bit more than us. But we controlled the game, we controlled the areas, and it's just very frustrating when you have 7 or 8 opportunities in the second half, kick to touch with penalties, and we just cough up the ball. It's not good enough at this level.
For the game next week, what do you think the team need to work on, and what are you going to bring to the field?
Our line-out ball for one, attacking line-out ball, especially in the final third, and just our accuracy again, more of the same things. There was a lot of good there, and that's the most frustrating thing.
Well, thanks so much, Mike. Commiserations, and hope have a good evening.
Okay, thank you.
And I've also got with me Aaron, who is the winning coach for Bath. Congratulations, Aaron. Fitting win today.
Yeah, thanks, Ollie.
How do you think the game went?
Very tight with it, but quite an exciting game for 17-14. So, really pleased, but really pleased with another win. But
what do you think made the difference this evening? I mean, it was a very tight fought match. It was hard, exciting. What do you think Bath did today that was different to Leeds?
Oh, we just continue to work hard for each other, which is really encouraging. We're having a crack, trying to back ourselves. Again, our defence has been fairly good. I think we haven't seen the best of us yet. I know the players are thinking that. And we just keep moving on. So, pleased with 3 wins in a row, but, this is a tough league. And, we're not at Christmas yet.
Well, let's see you carry on to the next game. Well, congratulations, and I hope you have a good evening.
Thanks very much.
Thank you very much. And we have the captain of Bath this evening. We've got Will. Will, congratulations, fantastic game, really exciting, super hard I imagine. So how do you think that went for the team?
Yeah, very physical game like you said. I think we did well. We saw at half time momentum was going to shift for us and we just had to stick with it. And in the end we just pulled through and got the win.
A little bit rough out there, I saw there's a yellow card first half with Josh there and a little bit of a scrap. How was that for you guys?
Yeah, I mean, I think we knew with Leeds they were going to take physicality to us. We did well to stay in there. Obviously, we try and keep our boys out of it, but we said that we weren't going to take a backward step today. So sometimes it gets a bit flary out there, and it did today.
Well, congratulations, and I hope you have a really good night celebrating with the team.
Brilliant. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Will. Cheers. So that sums up a great day of BUCS Super Rugby. Final score 17-14 to Bath. Join us tomorrow night where we take on Durham versus Cardiff Met. Thank you very much and good night.